Let's say we have a struct in Rust that we call product, and it has a name and a price. Now, in other languages, if you want to define methods for this struct, you will come in here and then start defining it. But in Rust, you will need to use the implementation keyword this way. And then let's say we implement a method that we call getPrice. And we make it a method, and then it's going to return F64. Perfect. Now we can get an instance of that product. Now we have a product with a name, product 1, and then the price of $30. Now we can print this to the terminal just so you can see it. In order to print that, we needed to implement this debug thread. Okay. Now if we run the code, we get product equal to product with the name and the price. Now, the advantage this has over other languages is that you can even go inside another file and then implement more methods for this particular type called products. So this gives you a lot of advantages and then allow you to do whatever you want here. Because if you're doing it inside this product struct directly, you'll be limited to the number of methods you can implement for this particular struct type. Now in JavaScript, you have the prototype, where you can create prototypes for objects that allow you to do something like this as well. Now this product struct has this method called getPrice. Now if we want to enforce this, we can create a thread to enforce that this product must have this getPrice method. And to do that, we can create a thread that we'll call priceable. Okay, and then we say it will have a function called getPrice, and then that it will return type of F64, and then implement the priceable thread for this product. In order to make it method as well, we add this self parameter right here. Okay, so now whenever we have an instance of product, we are sure that it will implement this priceable thread, and therefore it's going to have this method. So now, just like we are able to implement any method we want, right, for this struct separately, can we do that for inbuilt types as well, for example integers? And the answer is yes. In Rust, you have something called blanket implementation, where we can also implement this thread, priceable thread, for inbuilt types as well, for example an integer. Okay, let me show you how to do that. So coming down here, we can say something like this. Since we know that the integer type implements the display thread, we can then hook on that and then instruct it to also implement this priceable as well. So a real life implementation will be something like this. Okay, where you have these three clubs, Chelsea, Barcelona and Real Madrid, they all implement this interface right here called Plays in Europe, because they all play in Europe. Now let's say we come along and we also want every player that plays for this club to be able to travel around Europe, right? Instead of implementing this interface for these types separately, we can just target this common thread they already have and then implement this particular interface for them in a group. So that way we don't have to implement them separately, right? So once we do that, we'll now be instructing Rust to implement this particular thread for every type, structs or whatever, that implements this place in Europe interface. And that's similar to what we need to do here. Since we want the integer type to implement this getPrice as well, okay, and we know that the integer type also implements the display thread, we can hook on that and then instruct the integer type to implement getPrice as well. So what we can do is to come in here and then we say implement for any type T using generics. You should take a look at this video where we treated threads. We devoted some series to treating threads as well. This is also part of the video, by the way. And we also devoted some videos to treating generics as well. So we are going to implement the power of generics here. and say implement for any type that implements the display thread. Since we already know that the integer type will implement the display thread, and then implement priceable for t, and then we can then implement the members. Let's say all we have to do here is to print something to the terminal. You can just return 0.0 just to make this happy. Okay, so now all of a sudden, for integers that we know that implements this display thread, we are also implementing getPrice method to them by forcing the integer type, by forcing any type that implements this display thread to also implement the priceable thread. And then to use it, you can test it out here. Let's say let number of products, and we set it to 45, for example. Now we have an integer, okay, and then we can print that to the terminal to see if it's going to work. And then we can call num of products dot get price. Then if we run that code, we get right here. Now getting price of integer. So somehow we are now able to implement this get price method inside this thread for integers as well. Okay, now this all sounds really good, right? You can implement any method for even existing types and also for your own types, but it causes some problem in certain cases, and that is what we are going to take a look at in the next video, where we explore what is called coherence in Rust and how they can pose very huge problems and how Rust handles it as well. So make sure you subscribe and like the video, so that in the next video when we explore this, you're going to be notified as well.